What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to Johnny K Picks. In this video, I'm going to break down the bets that I made for UFC Vegas 42, Holloway versus Rodriguez. So before I get started, I have a new announcement. So I just started up Johnny K Picks on Twitter. Yes, I know I'm super late to the party, but if you're on Twitter, you can go ahead and follow me at Johnny K Picks. The link will be in the description. As always, go ahead and smash that like and subscribe button for me. Also, make sure you turn on those notifications so you don't miss out on any of my content. And lastly, if you want a more in-depth breakdown of my picks and predictions, please feel free to go ahead and watch my Johnny K Picks video that I posted earlier this week. Okay, so real quick before I get into my bets for UFC Vegas 42, I'm going to quickly recap the bets that I did for UFC 268, Usman versus Covington. So overall, I ended up winning 8.16 units profit. I won my first two-fighter parlay, my three-fighter parlay, my underdog bet, and finally, I hit my Johnny K Crazy seven-fighter parlay. It's been a while since I hit one of those, but hey, when it's your night, it's your night. The bets that I did miss on was the Gaethje knockout prop. Honestly, that was a really good fight. Actually, Gaethje almost knocked him out in the second round, so either way, I'm not too mad about that bet. And the second two-fighter parlay that I missed on, I had Phil Hawes winning, and yeah. I'm sure a lot of people had Phil Hawes winning as well. I don't know about his chin, man. I just don't know anymore. He has all the talent in the world. He can take you down. He can strike. He has the cardio. But that chin, the whole fight, the whole first round, except with like 20 seconds left, he was winning. And then he got hit once. And then he went down like a sack of potatoes. His chin is put on notice right now. So, yeah, that's all I'm going to say about that. Okay, so without further ado, let's get to my bets for UFC Vegas 42, Holloway versus Rodriguez. So for my first bet, I'm gonna do something different and something fun. As I mentioned earlier, I just started up a Twitter for Johnny K Picks, and for this bet, I wanna leave it up to my viewers. So if you go to my Johnny K Picks Twitter page, not right now, after you watch this video, you'll see that I posted a poll of two fighters, which are Ben Rothwell and Miguel Baeza. So all you gotta do is pick the fighter that you wanna bet on and think is gonna win. And on Saturday morning before the fight start, I'm gonna place a one unit bet on the fighter who has the most votes. I'm not exactly sure how this is gonna go down, but I'm hoping it goes over well. I hope everybody just has a little bit of fun. Even if you don't wanna bet this bet, just go on my Twitter page and vote which one you think is gonna win. But here's the best part. So let's say this bet wins. Next week, I'm gonna roll over the payout into another poll that I'm gonna do on Twitter for the following week's bet. So I'm gonna see how far we can go with this. So maybe if we hit it like four or five times, we can stop and start over. Or hey, we just keep going. Also, don't forget to follow me on Twitter. All right, so enough fun and games here. So let's get back to my second bet of the night, which is an underdog bet. I have a one unit bet on Arce to win, and I got that at plus 115. So as I mentioned in my earlier video that I posted, I do think both fighters are really good strikers, but I would give the slight edge to Arce. I think he's a really good boxer. And if he wants to take the fight to the mat, I think he can get Yadong down. And another thing to note here is Arce has been fighting in the featherweight division, so this will be his first fight in the bantamweight division. So he's used to the bigger fighters and maybe the more powerful guys, so I really think that he's gonna be able to hold his own down a weight division. I do think it'll be a fairly close fight though, because Yadong is pretty good, and he may win the first round, but I can definitely see Arce taking over in rounds two and three if that does happen, so I'm still gonna go with Arce on this one. All right, so the next bet I have is another underdog bet here. I have a one unit bet on Alvarez to win, and I got that at plus 205. So right off the bat here, I'm gonna say it, this line is way too wide for me. Yes, this is gonna be a very close matchup against two very good grapplers, but here's the reason why that I'm siding with Alvarez. Alvarez has a 6-inch height advantage, and also a 6.5-inch reach advantage. So I really think that Moises is gonna have a hard time trying to get close to Alvarez. So another thing that's worth mentioning is Alvarez has 3 submissions when his opponent takes him down. So that leads me to my next question. Is Moises gonna keep it standing? Is he gonna be okay with taking him down? Because you have to remember, Moises did just fight Makhachev and he lost by submission. I think that was his first time he's ever lost by submission. So if he does want to keep it on his feet, like I said, he's going to have a really tough time getting close to Alvarez with that reach advantage and height advantage. Also, with that big height advantage, Alvarez can get a standing submission, maybe a guillotine, or maybe even a rear naked choke, just from his height advantage alone. So like I said, I really think this fight is going to be a lot closer than the lines say, so I'm going to take a chance and I'm going to say Alvarez is going to win this one. Okay, so the next bet I have is a two-fighter parlay. I have a one-unit bet on Rothwell and Spencer to win, and I got that at plus 124. So I broke down these fighters in my last video that I posted earlier this week, but I really like both of their matchups. Rothwell is a strong, durable dude with great cardio for a heavyweight, actually. Sure, he may not be the most skillful guy, but he gets the job done, and he just keeps pushing forward on his opponent. He doesn't give them any room to breathe. And honestly, I wouldn't be too shocked in the third round if Rothwell gets a submission when Lima's gassed out, because he did submit Barnett in his last fight. And with Spencer, she's fought the better competition. She's the better striker. I think she's better overall fighter. And more importantly to me anyways, Letson hasn't fought in almost 3 years. So right there, this is kind of a no-brainer pick for me. I'm not trying to say that Spencer's a top-level fighter by any means, but she should be able to win this fight hands down. Okay, so the next bet I have is another two-fighter parlay. I have a one-unit bet on Young and Diakis to win, and I got that at plus 177. So for Young, I really think he has a clear path to victory here, and that path to victory is to get Kennedy down on the mat. Young averages 2.79 takedowns per 15 minutes with a 61% takedown accuracy, so I really think that he can get Kennedy down whenever he wants. But if this fight does play out on the feet, it's going to be a lot closer than getting that fight to the mat for Young. But I still like Young's chances. And for Diakis, I do think he's the more well-rounded fighter. He's good on the feet, and he can mix in his takedowns when he needs to. I'm not a big Alves fan, but he did look pretty good in his last fight. And he did show his cardio improvements, but I'm not completely sold on that. He does have cardio issues. Maybe if he shows in this fight that he can go 3 rounds again, I'll maybe change my mind. But until then, I'm going to pick the better fighter, and that's going to be Diakis. Okay, so before I get into my last bet, if you can go ahead and hit that like and subscribe button for me, I greatly appreciate it. Okay, guys, so for my last bet, you guessed it. It's the Johnny K Hail Mary Parlay Special. Again, disclaimer, I do not expect to hit this again, but I did just hit my last one last week, so you do what you want to do. But I have a half unit bet on 6 fighters. I have Young, Diakis, Woodson, Spencer, Rothwell, and Holloway to win with the over 2.5 round, all at plus 1158. So I touched on all of these fighters earlier in this video except Woodson and Holloway. So in the Woodson fight, he's going to be the much bigger fighter, the much longer fighter as well. And I think he can give Anglin some problems with that, especially on the feet with his striking. The only thing that kind of worries me in that fight, though, is Anglin does go for takedowns. And if he does get Woodson down, it might be a long night for Woodson. But I really do think he can stuff the majority of Anglin's takedowns and maybe even tire him out in the first round or second round. And with Holloway, yeah, he's going to win this fight. He's the better striker. But then again, Rodriguez is no slouch either. I don't think that there's going to be a finish in this fight. But if there is a finish, I do think it's going to be later in the rounds, maybe rounds 4 or 5. So that's why I added Holloway to win plus the over 2.5 rounds. Because it does make those odds way better than the minus 700 that you would have to lay just for the money line for him. Alright guys, so those are my bets for UFC Vegas 42. So like I said, I just started up a Twitter page. So if you want to go ahead to my Twitter page at JohnnyKPicks and follow me, that'd be great. Also, when you're on my Twitter, don't forget to vote for who you think is going to win that fight for the viewer bet. And again, if you want a more in-depth breakdown of my picks and predictions for UFC Vegas 42, feel free to go ahead and watch that video that I posted earlier this week. If you choose to play any of these bets or even all of them, good luck to you. Hope everybody enjoys the fights and happy fight night.